Going through a custody or timeshare battle is not oftentimes like it is portrayed on television. In my experience, it's not a good strategy or technique to throw mud at the other side. Certainly, if there are circumstances or facts that the court needs to know in order to protect the child or the minor children in those instances, then that's evidence that needs to be presented. Unfortunately, we do sometimes encounter the other side making unfounded allegations or alleging that you are not fit to care for the child for reasons that are not true or that are not going to be substantiated. Unfortunately, little things are sometimes exaggerated into big things. In my experience, it's not a good technique to go to court and throw mud at the other side. But if you find yourself on the side of this, on the receiving end of this, it's important that you speak with your attorney, that you tell them everything so that they are prepared to rebut these allegations in the best possible way. If your wife is going to allege that because you enjoy having an alcoholic beverage one or two nights after work, that you're an alcoholic and incapable of caring for the child, it's important that you share that information with your attorney. We will be prepared to have all of the best evidence available at a hearing so that we can show that not only are those allegations not true, but that your former partner is not doing all that she can to promote and foster your role in the minor child's life, that she is throwing mud and using unfair facts, untrue facts, to limit your timeshare with the minor child. This oftentimes translates to us getting you the parenting plan that you want, to the court adopting our proposed parenting plan. If you anticipate going through a custody or timeshare battle in the near future and your former partner is making threats that she is going to keep the children from you for reasons that are unfounded or exaggerated and not true, it is important that you speak with an attorney and that you share those concerns with that attorney so that they can be prepared to defend those allegations if that happens. That being said, in my experience, most good family law practitioners don't engage in that type of behavior. Those types of antics, in my experience, are not well received by the court. So please have peace of mind in knowing that your right to be involved in your children's lives is one of the most protected rights there is. And courts and judges see through that type of behavior, but we want to make sure that we're doing all that we can to have all of the best evidence to present to the court. Divorce brings out the worst in people. Hopefully, your former partner will consult an experienced and knowledgeable family law attorney that will advise them against those types of tactics. If that does not happen, we'll be prepared to handle those allegations and do all that we can to ensure the best outcome for you and your family.